Hello everyone. So I'm going to go through a quick demo about connecting SharePoint to Snowflake via Openflow. So I wrote this Medium article, and by popular demand, I'm making a quick video to just demo that so you can follow along. First steps we need to achieve that, you need to create a Microsoft Graph application. Grant that your application you creating permission to the site. I'm going to create all my Snowflake object. Then we install and configure SharePoint connector in Openflow. So this is with assumption you already have a deployment and a runtime. A deployment and a runtime is a prerequisite for this. So why don't we get started? I head over to my Azure Portal app registration. I do a new registration. Let me call it SharePoint to Snowflake. Then we register the application. But you need to grab the client ID or app ID. Then you need to grab the tenant ID. Next thing will be API permissions. So API permissions, so all of those permissions, I need to grant it here. So you get an API permission, then you say add a permission. It's Microsoft Graph and it's application permissions. So these four permissions is needed here. Then next off, after those four permissions, you need to grant admin consent to the organization. Next off, we need to generate a secret, client secret. So I do a new client secret. You need to grab it immediately. Aside the client secret, then you need to upload an application certificate. So you come to certificate, you need to upload a certificate. This certificate must be in a PEM format. So if you follow along, I head over to I signed into PowerShell as an administrator. Just follow like that. It should work. If that works for you, then I will export it. I will export it to this file, my snowflake.cer. I'm going to export that. So I'm going to put it in my Snowflake cert.cer and add that certificate. And the content of that certificate, you're going to be providing that in Openflow. So we need to grant that application permission to the SharePoint site with PowerShell. So I'm just going to connect to the SharePoint online service. You need to put in the name of your own domain right here. And I log into that SharePoint service. If that works well, then you connect to the Microsoft Graph. It might need you to authenticate, and I authenticated and I'm there. So say welcome to Microsoft Graph. Next thing is for us to grab the site ID. Okay, so the site ID, I'm going to put in my SharePoint site so that I get the share. Okay, that's it. Then what's the name of the site? So the site itself, it's called Snowflake. So where what I did is, so this is my SharePoint environment, then this is the site. All right, if it does that well, then just follow along. I create a variable to store that site ID. Then I'll mention the application ID, then just give it a display name. So then display name, I can call it the same SharePoint to Snowflake. Then copy this. So this one will grant your read access to that site. So if you get a response like this, then that is good. I'm going to Snowflake workspace. I mean, I'm just creating my Snowflake object, a user that I'm going to be using for Openflow, a role I'm going to be using. I create the object, the database, the schema is going to use. Why don't we just run all of this? If I run all, and this should be good. So we ran all of that. I attached a public key. You're going to be using the private key in Openflow. So next is now head up to Openflow. So in the Snowflake account, if you see data, you see Openflow right here. You can launch Openflow. In Openflow, there are several connectors. Today, we're particularly about the Microsoft SharePoint. I'm going to use the simple ingest. You can, if you want to use some Cortex function, but for today, we just do simple ingest. You had that connector, you need to add it to a runtime. And just as a reminder, for this to work, you must already have a deployment and a runtime. So I'm going to add it to my runtime. So once we launch the canvas, already had a processor group for you for SharePoint. You can explore this processor group. It has other processor group in it, and it has processors in those processor group. But let's just go to the main page. I will start with that right click and parameters. So parameters, so destination database, I put that there. Of Openflow sandbox, I created a schema, SharePoint test, all of those. So now also you need to now put what is the SharePoint site. So this is my SharePoint site that I already put there. What is the SharePoint site URL? So this is the main domain, so you put that there. But this one will have the whole length of it, so the whole length of it plus the site itself. Okay, so I put that plus the site. Then I am putting my tenant ID that we grab from the application. The tenant ID, I grab the client ID, my certificate that I generated. So when you edit, I put that here. Then if that goes well, then this destination parameter, source parameter is SharePoint, destination parameter is Snowflake. So I already put the database, I put the schema, this is my account identifier. We're going to be using key pair, so I'm going to put in the private key. Okay, you might create a private key service and use instead of this, instead of putting it directly like I did. So but for this test, I'm just going to do that. I've put my warehouse, my user, my role. So client secrets, I'm going to just put that properly. Okay, so if all is good here, then you say apply. The parameters are set. If that's okay, then I'll go back to my main page. My expectation is that if it connects to Snowflake in my account, I will begin. So this is the database that I have created. This is the schema. So if I refresh now, you see my schema is empty. There's nothing in SharePoint test. So I should begin to see objects created here. I should see a stage created where it will load those files from SharePoint. Just a simple way it connects SharePoint to Snowflake. So let's give this a try here. So first, I'm going to say enable all controllers. So all the controllers that is using behind the scene. Then I will also right click and say I've put in parameters, I've enabled controller. Then let's give this a start. So once the processor begin to run, when we go to back to our Snowflake environment, SharePoint test was empty. Now if I refresh, it should have created some objects. So you see right now it created a couple of tables here that it's going to be using to manage those files. Created file hashes, so if anything changes in the file, he knows. Then he created a stage, that's where the files will live. So he created a stage called document. I can see it right here. So I added a new file just now. I just added a new file, so I see this file already. So I just added this file. I'm expecting to see this also shortly. So look at this begin.doc. So this begin.doc, I just have these two lines. So if I come here and say adding a new line, and see what has happened. I've added that, but this begin.docs, if I refresh now, you see it moves it to the top few seconds ago. So because it's a brand new file to it, so if you download this file, you see that the real-time edits that you made in SharePoint is showing up in Snowflake. I mean, this is very, very, very lovely how Openflow makes data integration so seamless and easy. right? So share the video with other people if you find it very helpful. Give it a clap. My name is Olu Jonathan, and I'll see you again. Thank you.